going to be there. Claude, I think these picks that bands are, that Burmese Ghouls are going through, yeah, not really the most iconic.
I mean, Rockhart, we've never seen a Herit at this point. I don't think we'll ever see a Herit in, you know, the upcoming days as well. But it's very unexpected that I haven't seen a Grok band just yet.
Yeah,
I haven't
same
seen
here.
A Grok band.
I feel like the Grok band is definitely going to be picked up by Onyx. Maybe that, or maybe that's a strategy that the Burmese Ghouls are picking up on.
Open.
If ever, you know, they're going to go for something really strong, they can get the Grok first. Or get the Hayabusa or Selena second.
Yeah, and indeed, the Grok we will be seeing for the first pick. And Kaja, mind you, is still open. And also the Hayabusa, the Selena. You know, these guys are the Indonesian powerhouses. And these guys are these guys are the reason why Hayabusa and Selena is so strong. And of course, the Akai is going to be picked for Onyx Esports. And right away, the Lunox is going to be picked. And the Terrizla.
As
well. Just what you predicted.
Oh, man. This is actually pretty bad here because now they're leaving so many options open on the table. You know, Anti-Mage, they say he's a very strong Hayabusa player. And of course, that's going to be Sasa's carry, the stuff of legends as well.
His Leomord, Anti-Mage's Leomord was fearsome, you know, in the MPL Grand Finals against Team Resolution.
One of the strongest solo laners I've ever actually seen.
Very, very strong.
When I was watching their videos, man, my eyes were popping. Like, what the heck do these guys eat for lunch and breakfast? They seem to be so ready all the time.
Single-handedly turns around fights using that Phantom Seed. And it's just crazy to see how Anti-Mage and Sasa. We can't forget Sasa.
Never forget Sasa, man.
Anti-Mage and Sasa. The dynamic duo of Onyx Esports, and it's just these guys, you know, you always got to look out for them when you want to go for a clash. And of course, we got the Hayabusa band and the Lolita band.
Man, the Hayabusa band, definitely very interesting. I'm expecting Selena to come in here very soon. I'm not sure if that's going to be the case, but looks like they are starting to warm up to it. Esmeralda locked in here for Onyx.
All right, Esmeralda is going to catch some people off guard, you know, with the Falling Star Moon as well, with the shields. And of course, I want to talk about this carry pick real quick, because the carry is going to be a complete nuisance around all the map, because you know the carry is just going to end up split pushing.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, the carry will be the substitution for Hayabusa.
I'm still looking for a good solo laner. I think Leomord is going to be the thing that
pick.
This is all in.
It's
for
very
sure.
All in. They don't even have that type of disengage. The only person who has that type of, the two people that can have, you know, potentially the disengage is Grok with the wall and also the Lunox with the Order Brilliance.
So they have to make sure that they can make use of that.
Yeah.
I feel like if you use that, of course, it locks out some of the heroes of Onyx, but a lot of them have dives. Mm-hmm. A lot of them have like Phams, he can jump.
Yeah.
Carry, he can jump over walls. Same with the Kaja and the Akai. So I'm not sure if that's going to be a thing, mm-hmm. if he's going to be able to block the mobility, but I hope he can use it to set up some of those wild charges, you know? The wild charges that stun a lot of team enemies up. I'm very excited to see Onyx Esports go in action. Mm-hmm. I'm sure a lot of you guys are also here. A lot of the pro teams are also watching, researching what Onyx has to bring. And if you are excited, share the stream and cheer for your picks. Hashtag Onyx win or hashtag BG win on the chat. And we are loading up into the Land of Dawn, Burmese Ghouls versus Onyx Esports.
And of course, we have Burmese Ghouls, Ice Ice on the Franco, Ace on the Terrizla, Ruby DD on the Lunox, CGO on the Granger, and PVNDV on the Grok.
Of course, for Onyx Esports, Psycho on the Kaja, Drian on the Akai, Sasa on the Carry, Udil on the Esmeralda, Anti-Mage on the Phams.
And right off the bat, Udil already dishing out a lot of damage using that Esmeralda power in the early game. And Psycho, doesn't matter too much, you know, half health already.
Yep, very standard opening actually for both of these teams. The Onyx composition is actually a composition that wants to go a bit slow.
Yeah.
You want to take this game slow, get Sasa in good items, get the Esmeralda and the Phams with good items, and then win the coming team fights with a very strong comp. So that's something that Burmese Ghouls can take advantage of. You know, they can do this early game because they have a Lunox strong as well as the Grok.
For sure. And of course, as soon as Ice Ice, you know, Burmese Ghouls, the primary goal here. As soon as Ice Ice lands a hook, they want to get that guaranteed kill right away. They don't want the person who got hooked to be killed right away, you know?
Yeah,
they want to kill him right away, so they get the guaranteed kill, and it's going to be end up like a 4v5, and you know, it might be snowballed from there, but this is Onyx Esports we're talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
They won't be hooked that easily.
Good luck with catching one of these guys here. Of course, it's going to be Yudel with a dive in with a moonfall. It is going to be chase up, and it looks like Ruby DD gonna be injured a little bit, gonna be shaken up,
just
but he's still pretty good. Still
looks
gonna
like
go in for the
gonna
fight.
Catch him off guard. PV and DV will be able to back away from this one, and Psycho almost still not level 4, you know, still working on it, still level 3, and now he just hit level 4. The Anti-Mage, of course, proxying this bottom lane. They're pinging for the turtle right now, though. Franco will have an idea right now. A potential skirmish might happen. Are they going to contest this?
Oh, Onyx, of course, their very trademark style of objective gaming, getting that turtle 15 seconds
turtle.
After it spawns.
Yeah, 15
very,
seconds.
Very fast.
And look at this. The hook, the Divine Judgment is going to come into First Blood for Esmeralda. They're not going to come in for more kills. They don't want to be greedy. Onyx Esports, the teamwork is there.
Yeah, absolutely. They really have like a good read on how to rotate fast and how to start the turtle without missing too many minion waves.
They
I think
weren't
that's
scared.
Smart.
They weren't scared to start the turtle at all. I mean, they were so confident in going for that turtle in just 15 seconds. They ended it right away. And Burmese Ghouls, they didn't even contest for it just a single bit.
Yeah, and the Burmese Ghouls, they really don't care, don't they?
They
for the meantime, yeah, they're trying to use the pick-off composition. Because, of course, you have a strong burst from the Granger. Even though it's very early on, he does have good damage output. However, it's going to be a fight.
A potential kill might happen on Esmeralda. And Esmeralda will be the first one to be put down. And Granger gets that kill
Whoa.
As well on the Thamuz. The Hulk almost connects on Psycho. And Psycho with a turnaround right now. But the Divine Judgment is going to be used. But no, nothing will be able to follow up.
Man, that Hulk just hit a feather.
Just
I saw it hit the
wing.
Feather. Don't kid me. Okay, don't kid me, game. Oh, so we see a Burmese Ghouls 2 kill streak on the bottom side.
Oh, in the back line,
however,
though.
Out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere.
What?
Franco is going to be taken down by the Kaja. Franco so far
How?
Not making a single impact in the game.
That's
it is 3 minutes
good.
And 40 seconds in, and Onyx Esports already looking so strong. But despite that, it is still a 2-for-2 kills.
It really is pretty strong still from Onyx, even though it's evened up on the kill score. It's a very noticeable lead that they have here. Itemization looking even better for the Onyx squad. They are getting a lot of minion gold, a lot of jungle gold.
Yeah, a lot
so
of jungle gold.
They're
as
actually
well.
In a pretty good advantage in terms of map control.
And Thoms is just having the time of his life. You know, he's just left alone in the bottom lane. The bottom lane turret might actually be destroyed at this point, you know. And then the turtle has respawned as well. Let's see if Burmese Ghouls will try to contest this, because Onyx Esports, they're slowly repositioning themselves to get that positional
yep.
advantage.
Yep.
But look at this, Udeal already
boy.
Has an idea that they're going for the turtle right now. It's going to be another turtle dance, ladies and gentlemen. What is going to happen?
I like the Burmese Ghouls as, you know, they're predicting that, hey, these guys are probably going to get turtle next spawn. Let's wait there.
Let's
cap that out.
Let's not give Onyx Esports the advantage
yes.
that they want. You
so
know?
That's pretty smart. At the same time, Onyx Esports, they're just taking this a little slowly. Actually a bit slower than I like.
Yeah.
But right now, they are going to secure it. Animage and Udeal already wailing it to half HP.
And here we go. The turtle is dangerously low right now. PV and DV will be also put low. No mana left on this guy. And the turtle will have his health regenerated. And it's just a back and forth so far. They're all hesitating whether or not to go in. And the Franco's hook will not land on anybody. And they will go back to their lane.
You know why Onyx is just so having a hard time? In taking the advantage.
And there
it's
we go, the Divine Justice is going to connect onto the Linux, not even giving a chance for the Order Brilliance to be connecting.
Yeah.
That's so unfortunate.
You know, it's because of those signs, right? Onyx, if you notice, almost all of them are melee divers. Like, so there are a lot of projectiles coming from Burmese Ghouls.
Burmese Ghouls.
Shots from the Granger, shots from the Luminol. So it's very, hooked the Franco, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So
the
it's very
hook.
Difficult to get near and to get close to them. But when they do,
when they
that
do,
happens.
That
Lunox,
happens.
No escape.
Lunox, no escape. And Sasa, of course, converging on Ace right now. Ace cannot do a single thing. The knockup's
penalty
gonna
zone.
Come in, but will be taken down. Oh, look at
oh,
this.
Oh, boy.
That was a potential bat turn around, but Sasa will be able to take that solo kill for himself.
Yeah, what kind of marksman just stands in the penalty
yeah.
zone, doesn't care, gets you right on your face. That is Sasa's carry.
Sasa's carry indeed. The two people that we need to look out for Onyx Esports is Anti-Mage and Sasa. As soon as you give Anti-Mage the lead that he wants, he will be destroying Burmese ghouls. That is a guarantee, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, Psycho is going to look for the Lunox, but will not be able to find him with the Divine Judgment as well. PVNDV will be in big trouble right now. Hurricane Dance is activated, and Esmeralda will get that kill.
Yeah.
They will be backing away. They don't want to be too greedy.
Burmese ghouls got a little bit greedy there, seeing that, you know what, just one more Chaos Bolt. Mm-hmm. Like, one more Chaos could have gotten them a kill. But Onyx responds very beautifully. Another dive coming
potentially happen, and Drian is in big trouble as well. Dangerously low. Thousand Banner to get away. Whoa. And Sasa, will be back away. Granger almost sniping Sasa out. That was super dangerous.
It's beautiful how they're estimating the distance, right? Like, it's almost going to hit, but not really.
Yeah, almost not. You know, they're all melee. Most of Onyx Esports, they're mostly melee. And Ice should have been landing those hooks as of now. And Ace is being converged on by Udil. Will the dive happen? No, they will back away. Yeah. It's a risky decision, but Psycho's going to be tanking for them. He's going to come in. The Divine Judgment is going to be used, but will he fall to the tower? No, he won't. And Ice still not landing a hook. Just 7 minutes and 35 seconds in, but a Grok charge will be coming on to Udil. The wall is going to be put down to block Sasa out, but will that be effective? And Drian is in big trouble, being converged on by three people. What is this? Ice also going to be melted down, but will survive. And Granger in the back line just hitting and hitting one after another. They will be backing away. This is very bad for Drian and the entire Onyx Esports roster. But in the mid lane, though, Thames is just pushing the tower, and that was a very bad exchange for Burmese ghouls.
And Onyx, they got everything they want from that fight except for the kill of every gold advantage. Anti-Mage was just farming on the mid lane. Everything that they want, they will get. And that is Onyx. I mean, they're pushing their HP bars to the edge. 20% HP, 20% HP. We don't care. We will still fight. And they're showing that they can pull it off.
It was just, you know, Anti-Mage. It was all part of the plan.
Yes, it was. Don't take the bait there on the top lane. I will take mid.
Bottom lane
was mine as well. You know, we're getting gold, guys. You know, give all your gold to daddy.
Anti-Mage is just getting what he wants right now. Also, Sasa, despite having only one kill, the farm that he's getting is already too massive. And now Udil is going to be trapped in that pit. But will they be able to go for a clash? At this point, the Falling Star Moon is used, and Anti-Mage is dangerously low as well. Pops the ult, and Grok will fall, and
the knockout
will come in.
Sasa.
And Sasa, look at that. Granger going to kill the carry as well. They're all going to chase this down, but Anti-Mage won't fall. The Drian will be using the Hurricane Dance, and he will be destroyed as well.
Udil
in big trouble, will not be able to go for the turnaround. The double kill for the Lunox.
On it being thrown so many curveballs by Ice on this Franco. First Sasa being hooked in and being given such a hard time, and everyone else following suit. The 4v5 fights worked out so well for the Burmese ghouls because of the Lunox pick, because of that Franco pick. They have all the damage they need and the crowd control to back it up.
And now this might be potentially a Lord this time around. Will they be able to take that Lord, or will Onyx Esports contest this? I don't think they can make it in time, though. In the back line, the Kaja is going to find someone to hook in, and he will find someone. And Drian is going to come in with a Thousand Banner. The Hurricane Dance is used as well. Psycho is going to be falling up, and Ace is going to be taken down. The Terrorista can't do anything. That's three kills for Onyx Esports. The instant turnaround. They want that lead. How dare you kill three of our members?
That's right. For the meantime, man, Onyx Esports, they are slow to ramp up, but when they get into the groove, their team fighting is so good.
It's like they're giving Burmese ghouls the false hope. You know, killed three of our members. Oh, the false hope. But Onyx Esports just turns that around, kills three of their members back. You know what? That doesn't matter. We still got the lead. We still have the confidence to win this game.
So very, very aggressive play from Onyx. That confidence is really showing as well. So even Ice right now, after that really, really good hook, I feel like he's starting to...
The hook will land again on suppression, will come, and Psycho won't be able to do anything. The Onyx Esports will be converged on, but PVNDV will be melted down. Thoms with just the burst damage, and RubyDD looking for someone right now with the burst damage, but they will be backing away safely.
Yeah, there's no penalty zone. Penalty zone was used on the ground there. And therefore, Burmese ghouls are going to have a harder time engaging Well, and now they're just going to go ahead and farm, which is actually pretty okay. Right now, 6,000 gold lead for Onyx Esports, despite, you know, very, very close matches, close team fights. It's very impressive to watch. And for the meantime, Burmese Ghouls, they need to get on point because their early game advantage is starting to slowly go down the drain.
That should have, that fight should have been in Burmese Ghouls' favor. But despite that, it was a 2-for-2 kill exchange.
Yeah, and 2-for-2 is something that you would think it's okay.
It's okay, fair, I guess.
But the late game of Onyx Esports is coming a lot easier than they thought it would. That's the problem. The Onyx Esports late game, you can't stop this.
You can't stop this. Look at the team composition. It's such a late game composition for Onyx Esports. And Burmese Ghouls, they're going to have to find some adaption to this. Franco needs
their
to land
base,
these hooks. And Ace is going to be converged on as well. And Udil will be taken dangerously low.
God.
Just one hit could have done it, but Udil will be able to escape.
Yeah, too slow on the attack damage for the execution strike.
And the hook is going to land on Psycho.
Wow.
And Psycho will fall.
Brilliant
poke from Ice Ice. And we were just talking about how Franco will change the pace of the game. As soon as he lands these hooks, there's no escape for you.
Man, the boy wonder of hooks here, Mr. Ice Ice. What a beautiful play. And of course, it's going to be Onyx with a 4v5 for the next few seconds. What response will they do? Apparently, they just want to turtle this up. They want to take this slow.
They want to take this slowly indeed. And now the bottom lane turret is going to be destroyed as well. You know, PV and DV will be zoning them out. But I don't think Onyx is too affected by this. But despite that, they need to respond to this very quickly because they're being pushed in. The pressure is on to Onyx Esports right
now. Yeah, Onyx Esports is pressure. I never thought I'd say that, by the way, in the series.
I never thought I'd be saying that as well.
It's beautiful to watch Onyx coming from, you know, a bit of a... It's funny because they're so ahead in gold. I don't know why I'm saying that. They're ahead by 6,000, but they're going
and
in 3M.
The Hurricane Dance is going to be activated. The Thousand Pounder will be landing, but no, it is still a back and forth. No one still has died in this. Suppress coming in for Sasa, and he will be taken down. That's one less damage dealer to deal with. Burmese Ghouls is
going
so, so far. Udil will be taking two down. The double
Stop!
Kill. And the Thames is going to be taken down as well. Anti-mage. So crazy. Drian is going to be converging on Ace, but will they be continuing? Yes, they will. Psycho almost taken out. Look at this.
Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, Onyx Esports a bit faltering right now, but
that's chasing.
A 3-for-2 exchange, and Udil will be pushing, proxying this top lane.
The power of this Esmeralda pick, when everyone is compressed and everyone is within reach, man, it is just so beautiful to watch all that HP go into Esmeralda, convert it into shield, and then just absorb all the damage.
Absorb all the damage indeed. And it looked scary for Onyx Esports because Sasa was the one who first fell, and Psycho just waiting in the bushes looking for the Divine Judgment to just come in. But no, they won't be looking for more kills at this point.
Oh, Onyx, you're still kind of threatening here around the Lord area. And I'm pretty sure they think they're ready to go.
They will be ready to go indeed.
Will Burmese Ghouls be ready to answer? That is the question.
Franco on the front line right now, just looking for that important hook. Psycho is going to push him in, and look at this.
He will be staying.
That's one less member down. Can they still contest this though? Ace is going to be in the front line next. In compensation, the knockup is going to come in, and PV and DV still not doing anything. And the Hurricane Dance is going to be activated. Lodex is going to be zoned out, but will Drian fall at this point? Anti-Mage in the background, just converging on Ace, and Ace will be backing out as well. Udil will chase Ruby DD, and Ruby DD, you will be DD'd.
Oh, man.
You will be done for.
Stardust Dance hitting so many hits. I cannot believe that Udil, his HP bar is just white all the time.
Just
he's stacking towers, he doesn't care.
And Onyx Esports just responding to the pressure that Burmese Ghouls was putting onto
tower.
Them. And Ace, look at this, getting melted one by one. Sasa in the back line just hitting.
Oh my gosh.
And Franco doesn't even land a single hook. And Granger, not enough damage there, but he go back to your base. And look at this, Udil will be you.
He's not getting damage.
Him.
Look at that.
Not
he's stacking so
damage.
Many people.
So
he's
much shield.
He's immortal.
He is immortal indeed. And the mid lane turret is going to be destroyed. Onyx Esports looking so fresh, looking to dominate Burmese Ghouls right now. And PV, NDV, what are you doing? And ladies and gentlemen, Onyx Esports will take game one.
What a dominant performance by Onyx Esports.
Yeah.
You know what? The tower was hitting Esmeralda. His HP bar, the white bar, was not being reduced. That's how high it is.
Single-handedly wiping out the entire roster for Burmese Ghouls.